You know, it's pretty exciting. It should be a historic day tomorrow. I guess 8 points is what we're looking at for this record. And obviously, she's going to just blast it out of the water. And so it's going to be fun to see how many points she adds on to that. But, you know, obviously, Michigan coming in. Really good three-point shooting team as far as anybody can really hurt you. It's like one of those teams that's very balanced that, you know about Layla Felia. You know, she's their leading scorer, tremendous player, all Big Tenner. But then Lauren Hansen is just a really good transfer they got from Missouri. Really good. That was a great get for them. She's a point guard, true point guard, three-point range. They also got another recruit transfer from Bowling Green, Alyssa Brett. Again, it's one of those games where anybody could go off on you, and you just don't know, who it is going to be. And so they're kind of harder to guard.
Season. I mean, they beat Ohio State, they beat Maryland at home.
Yeah.
8 of their 9 losses are by double digits, though. Just kind of what stands out to them? I know you mentioned some things there. What stands out as some concerns for you that you guys have to face tomorrow? And what things do you feel like you guys can take advantage of?
Well, I mean, there are, again, the balance concerns me. Felia concerns me. She's really, really good. Hansen, I think, is a tremendous player. They're a good defensive team. They rebound well. I think those are the things that really bother, concern me is those spot up threes that they can, four people can really have the option of getting them. I feel like our post game is good against them. I feel like, we need to get out and run against them.
Coach, when you signed Caitlin, did you have any idea that it would come to this or close to this?
It'd be really easy for me to sit here and say, oh, yeah, I knew she was going to be this great of a player. But I think that's, you always have faith in your players that you recruit. You think they're going to do well. That's why you recruit them. But I don't think anybody could have ever predicted this type of success.
At one point, did you realize that her level of fame and stardom was different? I mean, was it during the Final Four run last year? Was it this year where you were like, boy, this is different than even what we had with Megan a couple of years ago?
Yeah, I think it took off during the NCAA tournament last year, kind of wrapping up with the Indiana game here, going into the tournament, and then the NCAA tournament for sure. I think that's when her stardom really, really rose.
You mentioned maybe
for you as a coach and a team, is it difficult for her stardom to deal with that?
I think it's something we have to always be concerned about. It's something we talk about because you're not going to hide it. But I think the players have done such a great job of not being jealous and understanding that what she does is good for our program and good for them. And so it's something that we work on, though, Scott.
You mentioned maybe taking a timeout after it happens. Caitlin said that she doesn't want the game to stop afterwards. What, do you have any kind of protocol or anything like that or plan?
No protocol. I was thinking about taking a timeout, but I guess I'll talk to her about that first, because if she doesn't want it, I don't think I want to do it.
Coach, you mentioned, you wanted this to happen here if it could. How special is it that this historic moment for women's basketball is going to happen in this arena?
Yeah, I think it's really important. I mean, here you have the Hawk fans who have been just so tremendous for us all year long. And, I mean, this is history, so you want to have it on your home court if you can.
How's Molly Davis doing, and how much did you miss her Sunday?
I think we missed her all week. She didn't practice all week last week. Definitely missed her in the Nebraska game, but she's doing better. She practiced on Monday, and so that was really good to see.
How much are you concerned or not concerned about the rest of them kind of watching Caitlin and just kind of counting in their heads what's going on? You don't want them to be spectators. You need them to be contributing.
That's, I think, been the case with our team all year long, is that we can't have the Michael Jordan effect where everybody's standing around watching her. And I think we kind of expected that in the end of the Nebraska game, to be quite honest. And so, we can't have that. Again, it's something that we talk about, and we need to make sure that that doesn't happen.
Does it seem, Len, that, maybe Caitlin breaking this record is going to be better for the rest of the team as much as for Caitlin?
Honestly, I don't know that we've really talked about that record that much. I mean, it's like you guys are talking about it all the time, but we're really not talking about it. I don't know if we've talked about it one time in practice yet or one time in a team meeting yet. Now today I plan on talking about it. That might be the first time.
Do you remember Kelsey Plum breaking the scoring record? Just what do you remember about that moment? And did you think someone was going to be able to do it, you know, not too much longer later?
Yeah, I remember when she broke it. I didn't, like, write down that moment or time or anything like that. I don't know any, you know, details about that moment. You know, at the time, you think that's a pretty darn good record and that it's going to be really hard to beat it. But I think Caitlin's setting a whole new standard that's going to make it really hard for other people to beat.
What do you plan on telling the team today about the record? You said you would talk to them about it.
Yeah, I want to talk to them about, you know, the significance of it and, you know, that we want to celebrate this. This is really exciting for our university, our basketball program, that one of our players is going to do this. So I want to make sure that we do talk about it today.
You've been your team, your program has been the standard bearer for the sport for almost a full calendar year now. And you know, going back to the game at Kinnick Stadium, sellouts everywhere you go, that can also bring pressure. It seems like you've handled it well. Do you feel like, is there a point where it might be too much for them? And would possibly a week off after this Thursday's game to the following Thursday be helpful at all, just to mentally kind of decompress for the team as a whole?
Yeah, I do think everybody's looking forward to a weekend off, which we haven't had really since Christmas. And so I think everybody is excited about having that time away from the game a little bit, the practice a little bit, the mental preparation. You know, you asked if it was like, you know, just the pressure of the season. And I think what's made it more pressure is that every game we play in is like an NCAA tournament. I mean, every atmosphere is like that, the competition that we're facing, because everybody gets up for us. I mean, you could see Nebraska, like, they thought they won the national championship when they beat us, right? It was like that important to them. So we're facing everybody's best promotions, everybody's best shot every single night. And then you combine that with the atmospheres that we're facing. It does feel like an NCAA tournament. And that can be, it can be taxing on you physically, mentally, and emotionally.
Is there a common denominator? You know, the Ohio State game, you lost a 12-point lead. I think it was 14 against Nebraska. You lost a big lead against Maryland. We're able to bounce back there. Mm-hmm. Is there something that you see in each of those games, and how concerning is that right now?
Well, it's concerning to us, definitely. The difference, the last two, the Maryland game and the Nebraska game, they shifted up, changed their defenses, and we didn't respond to that very well. Ohio State did not do that. That was just a point of them just, you know, keep us, we're fouling and getting them getting to the free throw line over and over and over again. But it wasn't a change of defense or anything like that.
You mentioned
the commonality in the comebacks that these teams have had. What gets them going?
Oh, I feel like it's the foul line. I really do. Not so much the Nebraska game. The first two would be that, but not the Nebraska game.
You mentioned that the last two, Maryland and Nebraska, changed up defenses. When that happens in the game, do you guys have, you know, offenses in place for that, all those defenses that you've seen? Is it just a matter of, you know, not being ready for it? Just kind of curious to, you know, what kind of happened in the Nebraska game. Do you guys have an offense in place to face that type of defense?
We do, yeah.
This a little bit. I mean, Molly's been sick, Caitlin's been sick a couple times this year. Is this something that you experience every season? Is this a norm, or has the illness hit this team a little bit harder this season?
I feel like it's hit this team a little bit harder this season, and I think it's been our toughest one since the COVID year, really, as far as people being sick and being out. But you know, maybe it's the pressure of the season. Who knows? Could be part of that too.
Do you think your team's inability to adjust to that box and one had a lot to do with Molly's absence and just not having that second ball handler on the floor?
I think that was probably part of it, yeah, is that we missed Molly on the floor during that time. Molly is a very composed individual, as you can tell, and so having her composure, I think, out there would have been really good for us.
Do you expect Felia to cover?
Yeah, we were trying to figure out who's going to cover, you know, Caitlin, and there's a couple of choices, but she's one of them.
Hey, Molly's also your second best shot creator.
That's a tough one. I think Kate and Sid have possibilities too, but I'd put Molly right up there with those guys. I think those three definitely.
Have there been any discussions about Big Ten protocol post-game situations since Sunday? like with the Big Ten office?
Well, there's Big Ten protocol, but we didn't follow before the game, during the game, or after the game. So I'm not sure why we even have protocol if we're not going to follow it. But, you know, that's the way it is. So
I didn't know if you had any conversations with anybody there.
I got a lot of I'm sorry's.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Thanks.